Hey there everybody, this package just arrived. As you can see, it's for marbles. This is the little tiny marble single bit axe, MA700SB. Okay, let's get it open. Okay, there it is. Wow, that is tiny. Looks like the grain orientation on the hickory handle is pretty good. I think it's unfinished on the hickory handle, but let's see what the head looks like. All right, there it is with some of this foam. They have the head wrapped in. It's stamped into the steel marbles. And it's kind of an in-between blade, like it's not super thick, but it's not super thin. It's just a nice in-between. You can see it has a steel wedge there. It looks like it is seated into the eye of the axe. Very tight. I don't see any gaps at all. So yeah, that's not bad. Looks really straight. It's got this oversized lanyard hole into the handle. This handle is tiny. That is a skinny little oval handle. It's got the throat and the belly shape, just not a lot, but it is slightly curved. It's got the nice shoulder here. I think this was listed as 1045 carbon steel, if I remember right. It's got a convex edge on it. And I don't know if it's sharp at all. Maybe a touch. You can see it almost looks slightly rolled over there a little bit. See that burr on it? That wire definitely needs fixed up a little bit on the blade edge, but I was expecting that. I took the sticker off. It does not come off easy. I actually had to take some rubbing alcohol and steel wool to get some of that glue off. But now that that's off, it almost looks like they might have put some glue on that head there too, even though they also put the wood wedge and the metal wedge. There is a wood wedge there. It's just very light. It's hard to see. At least I think it is. But let's get some measurements on this tiny little hatchet. Okay, this is 11.5 inches overall. It has about, I just want to take it out to there. So it's got about a 4¾-inch head on it. And the blade is about 2.5 inches. Okay. Feels okay in my hand. It's a little small. Especially on this like extra thin area here. Has a little palm swell, which is good. This shoulder area feels pretty good, like when you choke up on it there. Fits into my web of my hand there really good. You could do feather sticks with this. Split small kindling, because that's pretty much what you'd use a tiny little hatchet like this for. Handle feels very slick. You might want to wrap that, give it some grip. and put a lanyard on it. Let's see how sharp it is. Okay, here it is, straight out of the box. The only thing I did was remove the sticker. Still has that little burr on it, that little wire, but let's see if it's sharp. Nope. You ain't cutting no paper with that wire hanging on there. You can kind of rip it, but I'm going to strop this a little bit and see if that helps at all. Okay, this is after stropping it for about 5 minutes on each side. Oh yeah. Way better. Just had to get that little wire off the blade. Polish it up a little bit. Alright, I picked up a little cold steel aftermarket sheath because I thought it would fit, but I don't think it does. It's just a little too thick. Would have been great because that would have looked pretty cool. But so close, but it doesn't matter which way you put it on, it just doesn't fit. It's too small whether you go this way or this way. If you try to slide it down, the strap ain't long enough for the width. And if you go up farther, it's just too fat. So I don't have anything small enough for this. So that was I think I spent like 10 bucks. That's a waste of money on that, I guess. I did make this temporary duct tape sheath with a shock cord on it the other day for a different hatchet. And I think it would work for this. For the time being, until I find a sheath that works. Yeah, it works just fine. It's nice and snug. It ain't going nowhere. And it'll protect that blade edge. Looks stupid, but it works. Okay, here it is next to the Bison hatchet made in Germany. This is a small hatchet, so you can see how tiny this is. Here it is next to a mouse hawk, a little miniature tomahawk I bought off of Amazon from a throwing supply. And you can see that it is even smaller than that. I actually have the Grandsforce Brooks Cuban, the little hand axe. I don't have it here with me at the moment. It's stored away, but I know the head on it is larger than this, and the handle's fatter, but it's only 9 inches long, and this is like 11, so it's technically smaller, but the head is larger. So I think overall, this is actually the smaller hatchet. It just has a skinnier, longer handle by a couple inches. Here it is next to the Grandsforce Brooks carving axe. Well, there you have it. 1045 high carbon steel. Comes with a convex edge. There was a bit of a wire on the edge from sharpening, so you have to strop that off. At least that's how mine arrived. I've already lightly sanded this hickory, which you can probably tell it looks dustier color now. And I'm gonna put boiled linseed oil on that. And these remind me a lot of Condor Tool and Knife type products, which are also made in El Salvador. I heard that, I can't remember the name of the factory in El Salvador, but I heard that they make some of the products for marbles, and they make most of the products for Condor. So that's probably why they look so similar. So I think you're getting close to Condor quality with these, but at a fraction of the price. but I think it's a neat looking little hatchet. I also picked up these two small bastard files off of Amazon. They were marketing them as axe files, but I mean, they're just a typical flat file. Look like they're made in China or something. But they got a nice grippy handle. They're not huge, but I threw them in for the heck of it. Okay, here it is with a coat of boiled linseed oil on the handle. You can see that darkened it right up again. And I'll probably, over the next day or two, I'll do about two more coats. And, yeah. I think it's actually worth the money. This little thing's only like, oh, I can't remember, like $20 or something like that. Maybe 25. It's not super expensive. I hope you enjoyed this video. This is Joe Doomsday signing out.